online class, session 6. In the previous class, session 5, we discussed about the chemical reaction and its types. That continuation, this is session 6. Oxidation and reduction, what I'm going to explain for you. Oxidation and reduction reaction and corrosion and the reactivity. And once we recap for from the beginning to the class 6, whatever we discuss about in that. Discuss about the types of chemical reactions, all the four chemical reactions, explain you with examples and with the chemical reactions that you have to refer in a textbook. Next topic is oxidation. What does it mean by oxidation? This is also one type of reaction. Oxidation means that the substance gains oxygen. That means any substance, if we absorb the oxygen during the chemical reaction, is said to be oxidation reaction. So any chemicals, any substance, if we absorb the oxygen. Oxidation means if a substance gains oxygen during a reaction, is said to be oxidation. Whenever the chemical reactions are happening, by the time the substance, it will be absorbed oxygen or it will be gained the oxygen, that is called oxidation reaction. Example, we can see two molecules of the copper can be combined with the two molecules with the oxygen with the presence of heat energy. So what will happen here? Two copper will be adding in the oxygen. So here it won't be absorbed the oxygen, it will be lose the oxygen. So what will happen? The copper will be separate, then here along with the heat we are getting from the hydrogen also, you know, in the heat energy we get the water there. So heat means, you know, that already water will be present, the water vapor will be exit from in that hydrogen, along with that oxygen will be combined, then it will become the water molecule. So here what will happen, the copper will be lose its oxygen, you know. So this is what the oxidation reaction. Next is the reduction. Opposite for the oxidation reaction is reduction reaction. If a substance loses oxygen during the reaction, here it will be gain the oxygen. So here what will happen, it will be lose the oxygen. See here, example, copper oxide is there, along with the oxygen will be present. When once it will be combined with the hydrogen, what will happen, this oxygen will be lose, then copper will be get separately, then water molecules will be come. Like that, one more example, zinc oxide combined with the carbon, which will get the zinc separate and carbon monoxide will be separate. Here the oxygen will be loose. Here the oxygen will be coated in there. So this is the example for oxidation and the reduction reaction. So very important. Next topic, corrosion. In the previous lesson we were discussed about the metals and non-metals. No, in that only I have explained you what is meant by corrosion. That means any metals along with the metals, any other substance in the metals or non-metals or acids or salts will be appear upon them, then it become to some other new substance, that is called what? Corrosion. So any metals attached by the other substance around it, such a moisture, that means what kind of atmosphere it will be changed, means like a moisture and acids, anything like moisture means, you know, the water vapor will be appear upon the metals or acids will be appear upon the metals. By the way, the metals will be changed its character, it will be changed to other substances. So that is called corrosion. Examples I'll tell you. In our day-to-day life also you can see the shop, they are kept some iron things and all outside only, the monthly or weekly, they will be kept it like that only. So after that, if it is seen, means upon that iron things, some of the brownish rough things will be appear there, that is called rusty, you know, everyone will know. That is the iron left in the moisture outside atmosphere is become to brownish color, that is called rusting, iron rusting will be tell that. So that is corrosion method, corrosion product. Next is the black coating on the silver. So we are using the ornaments and all by the silver, no? That will not, if we keep on using that, it will be using by us, that it will be now exposed in the outside atmosphere. So the air, oxygen will be reacting there, then the silver becomes to black in color. Then whether copper, like electrical wires is there, no? That copper will be keeping outside, yes, it becomes to green coat upon the brownish copper. So these are the outside environment. What are the things are there? That may be the water vapor, that may be the air, it will be combined. Air is oxygen particularly, that will be combined with the metals, then it becomes some of the new substance, that is called corrosion. So a metal is attached with other substance around it, such as moisture, acid or salts, that is called corrosion. So this process is called corrosion. Examples, iron left in the moisture outside atmosphere and black coating upon the silver and green coating upon the copper. So very important, two more question, corrosion. important to my question, rancidity. That means when the fats in the oils are oxidized, whatever the fat foods or the oil things, or you know the meaning of fats in the oils, liquid items, the fats and the oils. This will be become to oxidize with that fats things or oil things. If they keep it outside, what will happen? The atmosphere oxygen will appear upon there. Then it becomes the rancid. That the fats and the oil become to rancid. What is the meaning of the rancid? Means their smell and the taste will be changed. That is called what rancid. So once the nature of the fats and the oil smell or the taste will be changed, means that factor will be changed. That is no use of to. Using for the cooking or whatever the uses of that will become too bad for our health. So that is the fats and the oils become to oxidize, means that become the character will be changed, that means the smell, that means the taste will be changed for that. After that we cannot use for that. So that is called rancidity. How to prevent this rancidity means to prevent this antioxidants we have to be at some of the antioxidants means whatever the substance we are using for that should be prevent the oxygen entering in that. That is called antioxidants. That means we are adding to the food containers or the food items and the oil items inside the containers means definitely it won't be spoiled, it won't become the rancidity. For example, in our day-to-day life also you can see in food items, you know, they are stored in the tins or in the plastic covers and all, no? So in that, for example, chips you are eating, any chips, for example, Lay's today, you are opening and you are eating, the chips are very crispy. How it will become? Because there is no oxygen inside that. Once the oxygen will be entered, means what will happen? It will become too soft. Once it will be open it and you are eating, then you are giving again from the air. So what will happen after the 1 hour or half an hour? Again, if you are eating inside, that chip will become too soft. How will it become that? And taste also will be different. You come to know that, you can feel that also, no? So that is, once the fat foods or the oil items will be become to the oxidation means that the oxygen will be along with that means by the time it will be definitely changed its taste and the smell. So example, keeping food in the A-type container, that's what all the food items in the stores, they are keeping in a A-type containers, they are keeping, it slows down the oxidation. So what will happen if you are keeping in the A-type containers means it will be slow down the oxygen, it will be prevent the entering the oxygen. So this is one of the important in the food. Oils and the fat won't be changed its characters means that is good for our health. We can use for that long life, it will be good for us. So that is important rancidity. Once the fats and the oils become oxidized, that taste and the smell will be changed. That is called rancidity. Examples, keeping the food in the A-type container, you prevent the oxidized fats and the oils rancidity. That is it. Okay, children, this lesson over now. What we done in the previous classes, previous sessions we discussed, and today what I explained to you, all together the lesson was over. Today what we discuss about the types of chemical reaction. What is the types of chemical reaction? What are the types in that? Four types of chemical reaction I explained with the examples. And then we discuss about the oxidation and the reduction reactions. What is mean by oxidation and reduction reactions? And I explained you what is mean by the corrosion process and the rancidity with the examples. So today what are the topics I explained to you is very very important for the exam purpose. All the types of chemical reactions are very very important. Each one of them they can ask for the 2 mark questions also on the 3 mark questions and in the big answers also they can ask. So each one of the chemical reactions, types of chemical reactions very important. Refer the textbook and all the chemical reactions with the equations we have to be right in that in the exams. And then today's assignment is explain the types of chemical reactions with examples with the chemical equations. How I explain each and every chemical reaction like that only. For example, combination reaction means write the definition, write the equation, check it once it's a balanced equation or not, write down that what are the compounds of the reactions names and the. Once you understand, refer the textbook, understand, then you have to write in a assignment book. And define oxidation and reduction. Second question is define oxidation and reduction. Very very important 2 mark questions in that oxidation and the reduction reaction. And explain corrosion and the rancidity. Already written in the metals and the non-metals assessment will be corrosion. Like here you have to write in the short form and rancidity. Last topic explained more that also you have to write in the examples you have to write. So whatever I given today's assignment is very very important questions. So I hope you all understand this lesson. If you have any doubts, refer the textbook. each one by one topic, you have to be go through the line by line, then you can understand easily and write whatever the assignments I have given in the last 5 sessions. Write neatly the assignments and go through. Next session, we will be discussing the next topic.